like in your video, like a little test, just a little something. It's late at night, I can't really sleep. Así que estaba tratando de acomodar algo más. No sé, algo que sea un poco mejor. Definitivamente siento que las luces, you know, just having them in front of you, like this bright, is so overwhelming in so many ways. But I don't see another way to have good visual quality. Super simple, just a white background. I feel like I could paint it green and almost do like a green screen. Of course, you know what I mean. Setting up this room and setting up a couple of things. Siento como que estoy estudiando, la verdad. Ahorita estoy en el internet viendo algunas cosas. If I'm like super, super honest, I had to basically leave my job. For health reasons. And I was so, I'm affected by my house, breathing wise, also health issues. So I'm a little, in limbo at the moment. I did just apply, otro trabajo, completamente diferente a lo que he hecho antes. Figuring things out right now. As like I have a lot of like going through my mind, and I can't sleep really. I'm having one of those nights. Now that I think about it, the AC is right behind me, and it hasn't turned on yet. Muy interesante, muy interesante. This video was supposed to be recorded. Remembered I washed a hat. I just remembered. oh, I just remembered that I washed a hat and I left it in the dryer. The hat might be ruined. Possibly. That's a possibility. I've been feeling a lot of phlegm still in my lungs. And I'm not consuming any milk. Quick update on my little journey. I still haven't smoked. I'm still doing strong. I try to stop counting the days because somebody told me that that when I'm counting the days, it's almost like counting my days to failure in a way. You know, like you have to be, instead of like, oh, I'm quitting, you know. They were telling me like a little better to see it as I'm being responsible. And if I'm being responsible to my body and my health, I just shouldn't smoke, you know. But I don't want to feel horrible. Or dread the day that I'm out with friends or something like that. And something goes down that I accept. But so far I've been very happy to say no. And I don't feel like I've needed it. Feeling pretty good. That's a good thing, I think, in my opinion. I'm still coughing out a lot of phlegm, and I still struggle to breathe at night. But a lot, like, not as bad. You know, I realized that at night, since I couldn't breathe, I would smoke to try to calm my anxiety, but then that would give me worse asthma, and I would just go on this loop, you know, on this loop that wouldn't stop. And I was causing that. So I think it's a good thing that I put my eye on it. Or my finger on it when I did. I think that's a good thing. Yeah. There's air. It's probably pretty loud. Not too ASMR friendly. But I think that helps right there, the door.
What was
that? Yeah, spilling drinks. I have this really cool idea. Cleaning the world with ASMR, which is I want to go to a location, which I already know where I want to go, and I want to pick up all the trash there and make ASMR with it, so I can do two things at once. I think that would be really cool, because it's like double kill. Jump shot, if you may. Trick shot. yeah, I think that would be like a really cool idea that I'm most definitely gonna do. I remember when I was in high school, I didn't have any way to make money. Spend like $60 on candy and sodas and chips and all the bad stuff, all the good bad stuff, and I would put it in a bag. I would like cool the sodas in the fridge the day before, like at night. I would stock the fridge And then in the morning, I would pack my bag. I would like have an extra Nike bag or whatever it was, like an extra sports bag, right? I would load it up, you know, just stuff it with like very specific, like I had the long Laffy Taffys, you know, I would like have a pocket for those. And then I would buy the tiny Takis, and I would have like a corner of those. And then I would have like Skittles and Snickers and what else? M&M's, gum, like the sour gum. That was mainly for me. I really liked it. It was really, really like taking a toll from Lou. And I would flip it from like $250 to $300, spending $60 on candy and drinks. So that's really cool. And for a second I was like, dude, I'm about to do that again. I'm about to like flip some, like honestly, like go to the park, like when it's really hot right now, you know, and sell some water, sell some drinks or something like that, while I find another job. Because like my job situation, I don't really like, it's complicated, is the best way I can say it, or that I'm comfortable with. Hustle brain is almost like in a way reactivating. When I was in high school, I had this idea that I wasn't gonna be allowed to do anything in this country. So I was like, yeah, I gotta do something, baby. I gotta make it happen, you know. I gotta do something. And I was always like about sales, and I was like always good at interaction, just being myself, you know. And at some point that stopped, you know, after I got out of high school. I was pretty like crushed with the idea of like what I could and couldn't do. So I let that in a way take me down a path. And I think it's time to get out of that, you know. It's not healthy to limit yourself from things that you haven't even tried. So yeah, that's just a little bit on me at the moment. Excuse me. Are you paying attention? Okay. Just making sure. Just maybe. Yeah. Just a little ramble on me. I didn't even think I was gonna like post a video, because obviously I'm shirtless and. Yeah, I was just like, I'm just gonna like point the camera to see if this like looks okay. But I ended up just rambling and ranting for a little bit. Yeah, I'm gonna head out. Yeah, have a good day.